Hello and welcome to this lesson, brought to you by BitMerge. In this lesson, we'll introduce you to programming languages and see where Python fits into the classification of languages. If you're new to programming, you might be wondering, what is programming? Or even, what are programming languages? Simple answers to those questions would be that programming is the act of writing commands to computers in a way they can understand, and a programming language is the medium for doing so. Programming allows programmers to manipulate numbers and text, which doesn't sound like a lot, but as you'll see in later videos, the most complex programs can be boiled down to the manipulation of numbers and text. An important note here is that programs don't exist on their own, but are parts of operating systems. If you're learning Python, you'll need to have Python installed on whichever operating system you're using. With that, let's look at what Python is. The Python Software Foundation, a nonprofit organization that owns and manages the intellectual property fueling Python, has a long-winded explanation about what Python is. The definition has a lot, but we'll look at the most important terms in this video, the ones we've highlighted in green. These terms will be useful when we get into programming in Python in the following videos. To begin with, Python is interpreted rather than compiled. Any program written in a programming language needs to be converted into a lower-level language that a computer can understand. Think ones and zeros, bits and bytes. Interpreted languages handle this translation to machine code line by line while a program is being executed. Compiled languages, on the other hand, go through all the program code related to a project and convert it into a lower-level code before the program is run. There are advantages to both. Interpreted languages are generally easier to make changes in, as you can see the results of your changes immediately, without needing to compile first. Compiled languages have the advantage of giving you feedback on your code before you run into errors, essentially letting you know that there are issues before allowing the program to run. Python isn't actually a completely interpreted language, it's what's called implicitly interpreted. There's more information on what that means in the description if you're interested. Python is also object-oriented. In Python, or any object-oriented language, programmers create what are called objects. These objects are structures that hold onto data. They have fields for organizing data, and procedures called methods for manipulating data. Person could be an object, for example. If we say the template for a person includes a name and an age in our program, then every person we create in our program has a name and an age. Similarly, if our person template includes a method speak, then all instances of a person will have that method. We'll look at this in more depth when we discuss classes in another video. Lastly, Python is a weakly typed language. The type here refers to data types. Integers, floating point numbers, and characters are data types that most programming languages have built in. Python's no exception. Python has all of these primitive data types and more. The difference between Python's type system and another languages like C++ is that Python does not require its users to specify the type for every variable in a program. For now, just think of a variable as a label that you can use to store data for later use, like name or age. Instead of requiring specification, Python determines the type of variables, which could be dangerous. This quality Python has of figuring out data types at runtime rather than at compile time is called dynamic typing, because it figures out the types on the fly rather than pre-execution. Ultimately, the question of what constitutes a given language boils down to the features that describe it. We've looked at just a few of the most notable features that distinguish Python. One final note is that Python is a scripting language, not a full-fledged programming language. Because it's not compiled, it's better suited for creating scripts that run when called upon, rather than standalone software applications. This by no means implies that Python is slow or can only handle small programs. It only implies that programmers need to be prudent with their choice of programming language, depending on the intended use. Thanks for plugging in. Your thoughts mean a lot to us. Let us know what you liked, what we missed, and what you'd like to see next, and we'll see you back here soon.